or anything like that. What's the strategy, the real estate strategy that you should utilize in a situation where someone doesn't want to sell the home for 8, 9, 10 months?
It would be like a lease option. So in, I guess in commercial.
Or just an option.
Yeah, in commercial would be like a master lease.
Yeah, yeah. And that's exactly, and you use a little imagery right now, a little conversational hypnosis where you put in my mind with the five senses and you say, sir, you know what? You're gonna go to, you're gonna retire. Where are you gonna go to retire? Oh, Florida's great, you'll have a ball. Can you imagine that right now you have this property, we negotiate the price, the terms, everything else. And then when you're ready to sell it, I have the first, I have an option or another strategy, first right of refusal. You can do either one. Okay, so you can do an option, not a lease option, because he's still running it and happy with it and everything. But in his mind, wouldn't it be great to have, hey, I don't have to pay a broker or realtor fee. I've got it pre-negotiated. And you're doing this in one phone call. Okay, how powerful is that?
That's powerful.
That Let's go into it. Yeah, I don't want to sell it till next year. You sound like a nice fellow. Why don't you just call me January or February 2023 or something like that?
Sure, that sounds great. And I appreciate you giving me that opportunity. One other thing before I go.
See, did any, I don't know if everybody noticed what you, that's an integral part of guts, saying before I go. What's the message you're sending to the prospect when you say that?
That I'm willing to get off the phone. I'm willing to, you know, show that I have authority.
You have authority. You're a busy man. You're a professional man. You sound like a millionaire. Even if you have two nickels left in your pocket, you've got to walk like you're successful. You've got to smell and sound like you're successful, because nobody wants to do business with a loser, a bum, or a crybaby.
Absolutely.
Most, you know what most people sound like when they're calling up prospects, right?
Yep.
Like they're begging. And nobody wants to do business with it. What do people, how do we treat somebody who's a beggar?
Oh man, we treat them nasty. Yeah.
We treat them nasty, we reject them, we bully them, we pick their brain, and then we dismiss. Hey, I gotta go now, send me some stuff, bye-bye, don't call me.
Yeah, exactly.
Is that the way you wanna be treated every day?
No.
Because you will not succeed in this business if you're treated, you know, the 11th commandment. You remember the 11th commandment?
Yep. It's okay to treat a salesperson like shit and still get into heaven.
Yeah, you can still get into heaven, you know, by treating a salesman crummy. And we do. What at dinner time? How do we treat sales uninvited guests who call us, text us, email us?
Yeah, it could get very verbally abusive.
Yeah, leave me alone. That's why they had to get robocalls or VAs and 12,000 miles away, because nobody wants to get that much rejection, because no one ever taught them how to sell like we're doing. Back in the role play. Sometime around January next year, my wife and I, we already bought a house in East Bumble, Florida, and we're going down there. We love Florida. We've been going there for years. I just bought a new house, and that's when I was going to put up my apartment building for sale. This, you know, I know it needs a little TLC. And everything. I've been a little behind on the maintenance, but I knew I was going to sell it in the next 9 months.
Okay. Oh, man. And sorry, you know, I appreciate you sharing that with me. And before I go, so you're going to Florida, you're going to retire soon. You know, your wife's going to be happy. You're going to be on the beach and you'll be able to relax. And you've done some great things within your life, 32 years of real estate. Imagine for a second, sir, just imagine.
Oh, I love this.
If in 9 months to a year from now, you know, you already have agreed upon price, if we were able to come to an agreement on price or terms, you don't have to deal with the real estate agent, you don't have to pay commissions, you got a property sold, you don't have to worry about any of that.
Slow it down a little.
Okay.
Make it romantic. You're seduced. This is really right now, I even give it a title, Chris. It's called the seduction.
Okay.
This is right now. And blend in. Claude, can you smell it? You're at Florida. You're walking on the beach with your wife. Do you like to go fishing and everything? And this building is all sold. You can go to your wife tonight and tell her, honey, it's sold. And that's what I'd like to send you an offer. Boom, boom, boom. And have this all behind you, all done. Go back in the role play.
All right.
This is the seduction now.
All right. You know,
I know this is hard with this face. This is hard to visualize the seduction, but this is when you're sweet talking me and using your words, sometimes slow, sometimes fast, sometimes, Claude, can you smell the beach already in Florida? Oh, and you're fishing down there and it's December and your friends are shoveling snow back up in Boston. Or it's Dallas. I don't think there's too much snow in Dallas, but.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. All right. Claude, can you imagine for a second, imagine that, you know, it's December, you're in Florida, you're on the beach, and you can just smell the beach water coming to you. You're
out there. Oh, yeah.
And your wife maybe is grilling. Your friends are back in Dallas.
Oh, we love grilling. You know, I go fishing on the beach. I go running on the beach fishing. And, you know, and if I catch something, my wife loves grilling fish. And we do it on the beach. You know, the smell of fresh fish. Yes. On some nice coals. And you squeeze a little fresh lime. Well, these little Florida limes. What do they call those little mini limes?
Oh, key limes.
Key limes. Thank you. Smart young man. And that fresh key lime on, a little salt and pepper. And we open up a nice bottle of Chardonnay. Oh, man, I want to leave now, you know?
Man, my mouth is watering just thinking about that. I think I'm going to take a vacation myself here as we get off of this phone call. But to sir, imagine that, you know, you're on the beach. You have the fish, the lime, your wife's grilling the Chardonnay and the
I can smell that lime right now. I love fresh lime.
Fresh lime mixed in with the beach air and the property sold, sir. And you can tell your wife, you can look over at your wife, smile at her and let her know the property sold. We didn't have to pay a big real estate commission. Everything's all done. And we can just go on with the next phase.
Okay. You got me thinking. For tax reasons, I cannot sell this property until January 1st because of my tax situation and everything. This is, I've owned this property 28 years. It's free and it's free and clear. Mm-hmm. Boop, boop, boop. And it's 20 units. Brings in... and I get $1,000 to $1,800 a month right now. And I probably should have raised the rent, but I've left it alone because I need to do some upgrades and stuff. So what's your offer? Are you pre-qualified with the bank and everything?
Yes, sir. I have the cash or the credit to move really quickly. But, you know, let me just backtrack to you 1 second. You want the property sold in roughly 9 months. So here's what I'd like to propose. You let me know, and it's okay to say no to me. We do an option agreement for my company to purchase the property in 9 months at an agreed upon price that we come to today. Does that sound fair?
Yeah, I'll tell you the price. I want $1.9 million.
So let's just pretend for a second, sir. If I say yes to the $1.9 million, what would you like to do next?
Write it up, send it to me. I'll have my attorney look it over, and if everything you say is kosher, I'm very likely to do business with you.
All right. And that,
what did I just do, by the way? I'm very likely. You picked that up, didn't you? I know you did.
Yeah, absolutely. You obfuscated.
I obfuscated. That's one of those guts $10 words. Obfuscation means basically I did not give him a commitment. I used a little bit of wishy-washy, something like that. And you want to get a little bit of specificity.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And when you say you'd be very likely to do it, help me out a little bit. What do you mean by that, sir?
Means I'm going to give it to my attorney. Same guy I've had for 20 years. Have him look it over. Maybe he'll contact you if that's all right, and just check your company and you out and everything. And I'll tell you right now, if I could get one, my 1.9, are you talking all cash or you want me to hold something?
Well, if I say yes to the all cash, sir,
give me a stroke first, because I just gave you a cookie. Don't let it go away.
Yeah, you did. You did gave me a cookie. Okay. You know what? well, how would what would my stroke be in that situation?
Let's. You want to reverse?
Not just yet.
Okay.
My stroke.
You know what? That's very generous of you, sir. I did recall hearing. Would you, instead of getting all that cash and paying capital gains and giving a big chunk of it to the IRS, you know, it's really smart of you, sir. Suppose there was a way that you could get close to, you could get your price, and you could also get a stream of income like an annuity, like an insurance policy. So you, while you're on the beach in Florida, we're back to the beach again, make it real. You know, you're hearing the seagulls squawking. It's that warm 85 degree breeze hitting you and everything. And you're getting every month on the first, you get that lovely check, more money than you'll ever need to pay your bills, to go to the early bird special, if that's what you like, or send the money to the grandkids or your kids. You just get that nice annuity. And everything is protected by your lien and ownership of the building. Or we can mix it up. You could get some cash, and you could maybe carry the other 50% of your equity. Could we? Are you comfortable with that, sir? How do you feel about it? Thank you for bringing that up. I can tell I'm talking with a very sharp investor. Thank you. I'm learning so much from you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
see, do you see what we're doing in one damn phone call?
Yes, definitely.
One call, we are, and even if this guy says no or whatever, is this a good phone call?
Absolutely. This guy will remember you, man.
He
will remember you for the rest of his life, probably.
Yeah, but I meant for me, the salesman.
Yes.
I'm the only guy in the world says the salesman comes first.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Okay? The salesman comes first.
Definitely.
And the thing about it is, how important is it, if we're going to be an independent, successful investor, that we protect ourselves?
That's most best paramount to everything. Our ego must be protected in order for us to continue to do this business and be successful at it.
Yeah. Yeah. We got to protect our ego. People say no to me all the time, but if I'm having conversations just like this, mm-hmm, it's mm-hmm. so valuable for me to, I can make the next call and the next call.
Definitely.
And then I can, somebody's going to say yes eventually if I use this gut system, mm-hmm. and I have conversations just like this. Are they all this great? Of course not. But if I can just open the door, see, we don't know how to open the door. We don't know how to engage people anymore.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
we've
mm-hmm.
lost that skill. And when we go call up people and we just, hi, how are you today? Just reaching out. You know,
mm-hmm.
you know what goes through their head.
Right, yeah. Mm-hmm. We're turned off immediately.
They're turned off, man. They say, oh, another one of these guys? Oh, God, go away. Leave me alone. And they reject you hard. See, It's like they made an immediate judgment on you. They don't know anything about the context of your character, what the kind of offer you make. They've made an immediate negative judgment on you because of the words you use, the way you sounded and approached them. So why don't we change that? Scripts suck. I heard another guru the other day. Oh, we got to use my scripts and everything. No, your scripts are BS because you don't know the person and the personality yet. You've got to adjust. You've got to fly. You've got to think on your feet real fast.
Yes.
And you've got to do something dangerous. We call pattern interrupts.
Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Sir, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It took me so long to get back to you. I got you posted here. Your phone number here. My name's Claude Diamond. This isn't about real estate, is it?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Why am I calling, sir? Ring, ring. Hi. Why am I calling you? Mm-hmm. Well, you called me. You're right, sir. I got your, you ever have a phone number on your desk and you didn't know what, I had to call you, sir. I didn't know if it was important or not. Well, this isn't, you're not my attorney or something, are you?